So we enter this magical land through King's Cross Station? How utterly normal, Rebecca muttered, knowing that everyone would be able to hear her loud and clear. While Damon, Cole, Bonnie, Caroline and Jeremy shared Rebecca's sentiment, the others were more thoughtful. Lily let out a tinkling laugh, her emerald eyes glowing mischievously. I thought the same thing when I was 11. But let me tell you, it's more incredible than you could even imagine, she smiled fondly as they followed Venus to platforms 9 and 10. Packed with moles, of course. I thought you said that there is a statute of secrecy? Bonnie asked, staring at Lily in confusion. They all backed up slightly when they found Lily Potter to be seething, looking like she had an axe to grind, and she spat out, "There is." They turned round to see that the owner of the voice belonged to a plump woman with red hair, surrounded by four boys all with flaming red hair and a little girl with red hair as well. They were all pushing a trunk and one of them even had an owl. "Now, what's the platform number?" the plump woman asked. The little girl holding her hand piped up, 9 3/4. 9 3/4? Cole blurted out in disbelief. How ridiculous, if I didn't know magic existed I would have thought she was a loony, Caroline sniggered. However, they all had gaping jaws once they witnessed the oldest boy run right through the wall and disappear from their view entirely. Whoa! Damon and Jeremy gasped out. That's so. There's no other word but magical, Rebecca wondered. They were all in awe. There was a difference between hearing about something that was assumed to be impossible and seeing it with your own two eyes, and the 10 supernaturals found themselves gobsmacked. Once the mischievous red-haired twins passed through the barrier, Venus walked over to the plump woman. Excuse me. Hello, dear, she smiled down at Venus. First time at Hogwarts? Ron's new, too. Not quite a looker, isn't he? Cole smirked as they all turned to the youngest boy, who was tall and gangly with freckles, big hands and feet and a long nose. Rebecca smacked Cole, "Don't be cruel." Before Cole could retort, the view changed just as Venus ran between the platforms 9 and 10 and they found themselves in a compartment where Venus had made herself comfortable. Lily, are you okay? Elena asked cautiously. Since the plump woman appeared with her five children, Lily has been in a murderous rage, her emerald eyes glinting with barely concealed fury. Lily merely shook her head. You'll find out soon enough. Hey, it's you. The brunette girl Venus ran into in diagonally appeared in the compartment. Mind if I sit with you? If I have to hear one more annoying lecture from my brother about how I should behave, I'm gonna explode. How come an American girl got accepted to a Scottish magical school? Elijah asked curiously. Some magical children get accepted to more than one magical school. There is more than one in every country. Venus, however, was registered in Hogwarts by James and me since before she was born. That is why she got only one letter from Hogwarts, Lily explained. He can't be that bad, can he? Venus asked hesitantly as an afterthought, but there was a smile playing on her lips. Alex scoffed and took a seat beside her. He's annoying. And a teacher's pet. And a kiss ass, you do the math or whatever. The 10 supernaturals and Lily smiled fondly as they listened into the two girls chatting and becoming fast friends. Alex Russo apparently lived in a small town called Waverley's Place. She had an older brother, Justin, by 1 year and a younger brother by 2 years called Max. Just as Venus was about to talk about herself, the compartment door opened and the youngest redhead boy walked in. Anyone sitting there? He asked, pointing to the seat opposite to them. Everywhere else is full. No, it isn't. I just passed by every compartment and I found many empty ones, Alex shot back, staring at him rudely. Lily growled at that, only succeeding in confusing the 10 supernaturals even more. Before another word could be traded between the three 11-year-olds, the two redhead twins popped up behind their brother, "Hey Ron. Listen, we're going down the middle of the train. Lee Jordan's got a giant tarantula down there," the other twin said. "Right," Ron mumbled. Alex, however, gasped, "A tarantula? That's so awesome." The twins smirked at her. "American accent, are you by any chance related to Justin Russo?" Alex rolled her eyes, but placed an innocent yet friendly smile on her face. "Hi, I'm Alex Russo, and I like to poke things with a stick."
"You mean your wand?" Venus asked in amusement.
"Oh, I like her," Cole and Damon grinned, before glaring at each other in sync.
"Why do we keep saying the same things?" Cole whined.
Damon facepalmed. "You think I want to be similar to the crazy original?"
"Enough." Klaus, Elijah and Stefan snapped, not wanting another petty argument to break out between their volatile brothers.
"I like to poke things with a stick."
Caroline giggled, ignoring the animosity in the air.
The twins laughed at that, and one of them stepped forward, "Venus, Alex. We didn't introduce ourselves. How rude." His eyes twinkled with mischief. "We're Fred and George Weasley. And this is Ron, our brother. See you later then."
"How did they know Venus?" Stefan asked in perplexity.
"They ran into her when she was trying to get her trunk in the compartment and they helped her out," Lily informed them matter-of-factly.
"And they left, leaving Ron behind and giving the girls no choice but to allow him to sit with them in the same compartment."
"Are you really Venus Potter?" Ron blurted out.
Venus nodded uncomfortably. Ron looked like Christmas came early.
"Oh, well, I thought it might be one of Fred and George's jokes. And do you really have a scar?"
"Yes," Venus snapped uncomfortably once again. But Ron didn't seem to notice and leaned forward.
"Can I see it?"
"No."
"Please, come on."
She said, "No, dude. Take a hint," Alex scoffed.
Ron glared at her. "I wasn't asking you."
Venus growled at him.
"You were asking me and I said no."
Standing up, she snapped, "Now, if you would excuse me, I need some fresh air."
Alex gave Ron her best evil glare before following Venus outside and grabbing her arm lightly.
"Hey, are you okay? Is that how it's going to be? People only wanting to befriend me because of my stupid scar?"
Venus teared up.
"My poor baby," Lily sighed sadly, feeling tears well up in her eyes. "She's never had any friends because of Dudley, and now she's facing difficulties with making friends in the world she belongs in.
She's going to have to be smart and make sure that the people she trusts are real friends," Klaus said softly, "something which would have been easier if I raised her instead."
"Hey, hey, hey, forget about that loser. You have me. I knew who you were and I didn't care.
That famous stuff doesn't mean anything to me," Alex smiled.
"Now stop crying because tears really make me uncomfortable."
The two girls laughed and sat themselves in a different compartment and Venus decided to confide in her.
"Ron's mother looked at me weirdly. I felt like she was expecting me. I mean, she was yelling in a loud voice about where the platform is and talking about moles."
Alex scowled. "You're right. Something is fishy. She should know the statute of secrecy by now. I mean, we have the same rules in America."
"Thank God."
Lily sighed happily.
"Are you going to tell us what's happening or continue to keep us in the dark?" Rebecca huffed agitatedly.
"Molly Weasley," Lily snarled vehemently, "has gone to Hogwarts before. She had two younger brothers who went and she has seven children."
"Holy crap. That's a lot of children," Damon gaped.
"Has she ever heard of something called protection?" Caroline said rhetorically.
Lily smiled. "The Weasleys are known to breed a lot of children, but that's not the point. The point is, Bill Weasley graduated around 4 years ago, and Charlie Weasley did 2 years ago. She's been sending off Percy, Fred and George to Hogwarts. She knows where the platform is."
Klaus was well versed in manipulation, plotting and schemes, along with his siblings, and they understood right away.
Klaus growled, his eyes flashing amber, "Are you telling me that this Molly Weasley planned it on purpose for some plot against my daughter?"
"Niklaus, calm yourself," Elijah snapped wearily. Although he too was angry, there was no need to lose their temper at the moment.
Lily nodded fervently, "Yes, That's what I'm saying. My guess is that she wants to get closer to the heiress of the Vase-Potter line. Potters are a noble and most ancient house, one of the oldest, richest and the most powerful wizarding families. Venus probably is an heiress to other lines as well. My guess is that she wants Venus to join her family, Bonnie summed. Good luck with that, Rebecca scoffed. There's no way I am about to allow my niece to slum it with those gold-digging redheads, she growled. Halfway through the ride, the two girls bought many magical sweets and Alex began explaining them to her when the compartment door opened and a chubby boy with tearful hazel eyes walked in. Sorry. But have you seen a toad at all? Who would get a pet toad? Rebecca wrinkled her nose, a sentiment Carolyn, Elena and Bonnie shared as well. Lily laughed, Ron Weasley has a pet rat. You. Are you kidding me? That's nasty. Caroline shivered in disgust. Sorry, no, Venus smiled kindly. Alex piped up, you should ask my brother Justin, he's a do-gooder, he'll help you find him. Venus nudged Alex and gave her a sharp look, before addressing the boy, you could ask an older student, maybe a prefect. I'm sure that there's a specific spell. Thanks, the boy smiled weakly. Hey, how about you join us until then? I'm sure your toad will show up, Venus offered. I'm Venus Potter and this is Alex Russo. Huh, who would have expected Klaus Spawn to be compassionate, Damon quipped, earning himself 5 glares from the originals and Lily. She's my daughter too, you know, Lily snapped. Damon held his hands up in surrender and placatingly said, whoa, easy the mama bear, no offense, he smirked. Gaining himself many eye rolls, Damon Salvatore would never change. You can't help but to put your foot in your mouth, Salvatore, Klaus growled. The boy gaped at her in astonishment but said, eh Neville Longbottom. Oh, Neville sweetheart, Lily cooed. Upon seeing the 10 confused stares, she clarified, Neville is my godson. That makes him Venus' godbrother. Their eyes widened in comprehension. Recalling the scenes they witnessed from before with Frank and Alice Longbottom. After Neville joined them, a girl with bushy brown hair and large front teeth appeared and spoke to them with a bossy tone, oh, Neville there you are. Have you found your toad yet? Eh no, he answered. The girl turned to face Venus and Alex, I'm Hermione Granger, and you are? Alex Russo and this is Venus Potter, Alex said offhandedly. It was quite plain that she didn't like Hermione from the look on her face. Hermione gasped, are you really? I know all about you of course, I got a few extra books for background reading, and you're in modern magical history and the rise and fall of the dark arts and great wizarding events of the 20th century. Someone shut that girl up, Cole groaned as he massaged his temples. Yes, she's a bit too much, Lily said weakly. A bit? A bit? Rebecca asked in disbelief. Okay, Venus trailed off. Hey, Hermione, can you shut the door behind you? Alex asked sweetly. Hermione glared at her, stuck her nose in the air and left with a harumph. Alex stared incredulously at Neville, geez, how were you able to be around her for so long? Neville smiled weakly, she's not that bad. I think it's just her nerves acting up. Well, I'm not comfortable with this whole fame thing. Why can't people understand that? They just keep flashing that horrible night in my face, they can't seem to understand that I lost my parents, Venus grumbled, garnering herself 2 sympathetic looks. I'm sure later things would cool down, Stefan said calmly. She's like the new shiny toy that just came out in stores and they all want to play with. But then later they'll get bored with it and move on to the next new thing, Caroline pondered. My daughter is no toy. Klaus growled angrily. He didn't like these paternal feelings he was experiencing and a part of him wished that he never found out about Venus' existence. She was now his weakness, and Klaus was anything but weak. What house do you guys want to go to? Alex asked interestedly. Both my parents were in Gryffindor. but I think I'll end up being a Hufflepuff," Neville said forlornly as he stared at the ground. "I don't care where I'd end up. It's just, Slytherin was the house Voldemort went to. What's wrong?" Venus asked when she noticed Neville flinch. "It's just the name," he whispered. "I can't believe you said it." Alex scoffed, "Boo-hoo. I'm not afraid to say the evil overlord's name." Venus nodded in agreement. "If we fear saying his name, then we are handing him more power over us." "She could be a Ravenclaw," Lily mused. "Can you explain what the meanings behind the houses are?" Jeremy asked curiously. Lily smiled and complied. "Gryffindor are for the brave, chivalrous, bold and daring. Hufflepuff are for those that are loyal, kind, gentle and hold no prejudice over one another. Ravenclaw are for the wise, smart and studious ones. Slytherin is for the cunning, ambitious and sly. There is a lot of prejudice against Slytherins because Voldemort was one and the most of his followers were sorted into the same house, so they instantly call them evil, which is total rubbish." "I agree," Elena nodded vehemently. "There's nothing wrong with having ambitions and being cunning. Besides, there were many Death Eaters from Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw, and Gryffindor," Lily concluded. "The wizarding world comes with a lot of prejudice." Bonnie shook her head disappointedly. "Hey. There you are. Why did you ditch me?" Ron grunted as he walked in. "Seriously," Damon snarled in annoyance. "Kid can't take a hint," Cole nodded. "Take the hint, dude. We didn't want to sit with you," Alex snapped rudely. "Weasley," a voice sneered, and the blonde prat that Venus and Alex ran into in Madame Malkin's store walked in with two huge buffoons that stood on either side of him like bodyguards would. "God, seriously. Can't we just sit in peace without everyone bothering us?" Alex cried out. "You." The pale boy sneered in remembrance. His eyes then flashed at Venus. "They say that Venus Potter's in this compartment. So it's you, isn't it?" "Yes," Venus spat, edging closer to Alex, who gave the whimpering Neville a supportive smile. Ron glared at the pale boy and left the compartment, not wanting to be around him. "This is Crabbe and Goyle," he said, pointing to the two buffoons, "and I'm Malfoy, Draco Malfoy." "Watch any Mal movies recently?" Alex guffawed before doing a deep voice impression. "Bond, James Bond." The ten supernaturals held their sides as they laughed hard while Lily's eyes sparkled with amusement. "She does have a point. I really do like her," Damon grinned. Draco sneered at her and then began to insult Neville and Alex before extending a hand of friendship to Venus. "I want to tear out his liver," Klaus snarled. "Horrible manners, that boy. How outrageous," Elijah snapped. Venus stood up and squared her shoulders as she approached Draco. "You've met me twice, and both times you've insulted my friends. Are you that daft to think I would rather befriend you?" she sneered. She then pointed to the door and growled, "Get out." "You go, O niece of mine." Col cheered excitedly as everyone else smiled proudly. A red tinge appeared on Draco's pale cheeks, and he spoke in a malicious tone, "I'd be careful if I were you, Potter. Unless you're a bit politer, you'll go the same way as your parents. They didn't know what was good for them either." "How dare he?" Lily screamed angrily. "Yes, I'm definitely going to kill that boy," Klaus snarled. Cole and Rebecca nodded in agreement. "How can he say something like that?" Elena gasped, a horrified look appearing on her face. Lily shook her head sadly. "There are many different kinds of evil in this world." Alex and Venus punched Draco in the face and stomach in sync, and before his goons could react, they kicked them out of their compartment with the surprising help of the stuttering Neville. "He deserves more than that," Jeremy snapped. But they were all mollified with the punch. They found their surroundings change once again, and after staring awestruck looks at the view of Hogwarts Castle and the ghosts, they found themselves in the Great Hall, watching the Cat Lady, Professor McGonagall, reading out names from a list. "I can't believe a hat sang," Bonnie shook her head incredulously. and that same hat sorts them into houses, Elaine added. It was created by Gordrak Gryffindor, you've met him already, Lily informed them. Granger, Hermione. Gryffindor. Longbottom, Neville. Gryffindor. They laughed when Neville had to jog back because he forgot the hat on his head. Lily smiled proudly, he has the same courage as Frank and Alice, even if he doesn't know it yet. Bravery comes in all forms, Elijah agreed. Malfoy, Draco. The hat barely touched his head when it called out, Slytherin. Potter, Venus. The whole hall began mumbling excitedly, eliciting an annoyed look out of Venus. A few minutes later, the hat called out, Gryffindor. The 10 supernaturals began clapping. Congratulations, sweetheart. Lily smiled proudly, though her face reflected sadly. Russo, Alex. Gryffindor. It's not supposed to happen like this, Lily sighed forlornly. What do you mean? Klaus asked worriedly. Venus and Alex threw they are immensely brave and definitely belong in Gryffindor, weren't supposed to be sorted there. Alex had the hat place her with Venus, but it was written for the two girls to be sorted elsewhere, Lily explained. And you won't tell us where, right? An annoyed Damon pointed out. Lily shook her head, I cannot in case the future changes. Maybe with a different upbringing, things would end up differently. The originals traded comprehending looks, if they raised Venus then a lot of things would change, and probably for the better. Weasley, Ronald. Gryffindor. Oh, come on. Bollocks, Cull sighed in aggravation. He won't stop bothering Venus now, Rebecca snarled. Oh great, did he have to be sorted into Gryffindor with us, Venus mumbled to Alex and Neville who sat on both sides of her. Ron grumbled when he saw that there was no seat beside her and sat opposite to her. Don't worry, you've got us by your side, Alex smiled, pointing at herself and Neville who rapidly nodded his head. Albus Dumbledore stood up, beaming at everyone in the hall and opened his arms wide, welcome. Welcome to a new year at Hogwarts. Before we begin our banquet, I would like to say a few words. And here they are, nitwit. Blubber. Oddment. Tweak. Alex and Venus burst out laughing in merriment. Is he mental? Rebecca asked, looking quite serious. Oh, Albus. Lily shook her head fondly. He is anything but mental. He enjoys his odd quirks. If you say so, Damon muttered to his brother, I still think he's crazy. They gasped awestruck when a large buffet just appeared on the tables out of thin air. Holy crap. Jeremy swore. This kind of magic is amazing. Bonnie sighed, a wistful look appearing on her face. While they were eating, the subject revolved around family and Neville informed them that his grandmother and great-uncle thought he was a squib. He then told them that his great-uncle Algie tried drowning him and throwing him down a building to force accidental magic out of him. Lily went ballistic at that and began raving and ranting angrily. Oh, when I get my hands on Augustus and Algernon, I will wring their damn necks. How utterly barbaric, Rebecca gasped, she too didn't enjoy listening in on how his family tried to force magic out of him. The 10 supernaturals gaped in awe, horror and disgust when the Gryffindor ghost, nearly headless Nick seized his left ear and pulled, his whole head swinging off his neck and fell onto his shoulder as if it was on a hinge. Goodness gracious, what the hell? Elena snapped with wide eyes. The women all looked revolted and wanted nothing more than to empty their insides at the gruesome scene while the men turned a few shades of green. Eh, you get used to it, Lily said casually with a small smirk on her face, ignoring the incredulous look she had garnered from the 10 supernaturals. James would have enjoyed this moment dearly and she couldn't wait to show him the memory of their reactions. Whoa. That's cool and disgustingly awesome, Alex squealed, jiggling maniacally. Venus patted her stomach, I could do with not seeing that again though. You and me both, a green face Neville groaned. Albus then stood and made his speech. "And finally, I must tell you that this year, the third floor corridor on the right-hand side is out of bounds to everyone who does not wish to die a very painful death."
"What?" Lily and Klaus yelled loudly, causing the nine others to cover their ears.
Albus Dumbledore, my baby better not be in danger because of this damn corridor business, Lily snarled. "Why do I have a feeling that we'll be finding out about this corridor soon?" Caroline whispered to the rest of the Scooby gang.
"If Venus is in danger, I'll kill all that was responsible," Rebecca threatened.